Art can be daring. Art can be decadent. Art can be reckless.
It is dangerous when I paint.
Art can be sexy.
There's something really special about burlesque.
Art is everywhere. Yay! Today, we sit back and take a look at ways to relax. First, let the sound crash over you in a sound bath.
A lot of people come because they're stressed out and they're anxious and they need to give themselves that break.
Then, finding inner peace through meditation.
The best way of relaxing and focusing quickly is just long, deep breathing.
Also, turning your own bathroom into a spa getaway.
We wanted to make some sort of little oasis for me to be able to go in and relax. My 5 minutes to go in and just relax and get a few minutes to think to myself.
That's all next on The Art of Relaxation.
So many sounds come at us, even ones we don't hear, but just because we tune them out with our mind doesn't mean they don't affect us. My name is Jamie Ford, and I do sound baths, basically play with sound in various forms.
A sound bath is the ancient practice of using specifically tuned instruments that create waves of sound that wash over those looking for relief from life's many ailments.
A lot of people come because they're stressed out and they're anxious and they need to give themselves that break. Most ailments can kind of come down to stress in some way. And when we focus our mind, our body can relax. With the sound bath, you're giving the body an opportunity to come into balance with the natural harmonies of the universe. You have a whole hour where you're not with your phone. You're just laying on your back and giving yourself an opportunity to just receive. So just that right away sets the person up for healing.
My experience when doing a sound bath is total relaxation. I feel like I just kind of drift along into another little world, and before I know it, it's over, and she's bringing us out of it, and we're like, oh wow, that happened.
I just feel grounded, connected to the floor, the earth, centered in your body. Thank you all so much for coming.
Although you can use any number of instruments to create a sound bath, Jamie works primarily with gongs, crystal bowls, and tuning forks.
When I do a sound bath, I choose anywhere from 3 to 12 gongs. I use a range of sizes so that there's variance in the frequencies. And then the crystal bowls, I also will choose usually around 5 to 7. And then the sound bath itself is very improvisational. So I just play. And each one is unique, each one is different. And then there's a period of rest, of silence. And the silent time after all that sound and vibration is very important. It's after all of that feeling, all of that sound, to have the maybe 5 to 10 minutes where you just let everything settle can for many be the most magical part of the sound bath.
Each of the gongs and bowls have their own unique frequency that is used to achieve various effects on the body.
Each gong will elicit different emotions, different feeling states. For example, the sun gong brings in the energy of the sun. So the sun is like the heartbeat of the sound bath when I use the sun. And the sun helps us to build energy, life force. The sun is heating, energizing, and is said to be the doorway to other dimensions. You can hit the center. It gives you less overtones. More of like a heartbeat. And you can hear you start to get more overtones, a lot more richness when you go outside of the middle. This is the moon. More flowing energy, watery, cooling. So the crystal bowls are played by either striking the edge with the mallet or going around the rim. So here's a strike. So the speed at which I'm going around the rim and the pressure at which I'm pushing determines how loud it gets. So this is one bowl. I generally play them together, either creating harmony or creating dissonance, which also has its place. So this is a dissonant one. The tuning forks are precision tuned to their specific frequency, and depending upon the deeper frequencies, they're going to be a longer fork. So the weighted tuning forks, you strike the fork and then you place the one end of the fork on the body. I tend to use chakra points, acupuncture points. So these are unweighted. So these ones you tap together and create a sound. So this is more chime-like that you would use over the body or at the start or finish of a meditation or around the room. The more I move them around, the more overtones you get. You can hear the difference if I strike and hold or when I start to move them around. So more overtones, more chances for the body, the mind to harmonize with a frequency that's healing or appropriate for that person.
During a sound bath, Jamie plays both the gongs and the bowls concurrently, and the result sounds otherworldly.
The art behind a sound bath is the ability to be very present with what's going on with the group, what's going on with the energy of the room, to kind of see what's happening with people, how they're responding, and to artfully place the sound in a way that creates the best environment, the best chance for them to relax.
The way my body feels in the middle of a sound bath, it's almost like a meditative state, like you're kind of just floating on a raft, you know, down a lazy river.
Relaxation is something that I think most of us could use more of. So my overall goal with all that I do, and of course with sound baths and all the ways I work with sound, is to help people experience more joy in their lives, to have happiness, have joy, have peace, and live in that way and bring that into whatever it is they're doing and let people become aware of the healing effects of sound and bring sound to the world.
Coming up, finding time in your busy life to meditate.
One of the things I'm super passionate about is that you can meditate anywhere, anytime.
Then, this busy mother turned to an interior designer to help her unwind.
Sarah really knew exactly what she wanted from the beginning. She wanted a spa-like bathroom.
That's all next on The Art of Relaxation. Welcome back to The Art of Relaxation. We could all use more time to reflect on our inner thoughts and tune out the outside world. And some people use meditation to achieve this.
And now let's inhale again with the intention of bringing our highest self here into the present, into the room, into the body, so that we can move through the world through our highest human capacities. Meditation is being in the present moment, fully aware of what is going on internally and externally, and connecting to your own presence and being. My name is Anka Adhikar. I'm a yoga and meditation teacher and the founder of Allied Awareness. Allied Awareness is an online educational platform for Kundalini yoga meditation.
Kundalini yoga meditation, oftentimes called the yoga of awareness, is a school of yoga that focuses on awakening the primal energy within yourself and using it to guide you towards spiritual awakening and relaxation. A practice that sounds complicated, but is actually quite simple.
The best way of relaxing and focusing quickly is just long, deep breathing. If you want to relax yourself completely and let go of the riffraff of your life, the simplest thing you can do is lay down in a comfortable position and begin to breathe long and deep, very intentionally. 20 minutes of that will allow you to drop your stress levels significantly. There are many different ways of meditating, many different schools of meditating, many different thoughts of meditating. Kundalini yoga meditations, they work in a really quick period of time. You don't need 20 minutes. You don't even need 10 minutes. You can use as little as 1 to 3.5 minutes of a certain breath pattern, of a certain hand pattern, and you can start to change the reactivity in your body. You can start to relax. You can focus, and you can focus a lot quicker with specific uses of breath.
Through Allied Awareness, Anka sends subscribers video tutorials on how to meditate in the Kundalini method. She also conducts in-person seminars.
We're going to tune in with our mantra, Ong Namo Gurudev Namo. I bow to that infinite part of myself, that great teacher. That is my intuition and my highest faculty for life. So for this particular meditation, I tune in with a mantra, Ong Namo Gurudev Namo, calling in on my highest intuition. And then I place my hands in a specific hand position and I begin a breath pattern that's inhaling through the nose, exhaling through the mouth, inhaling through the mouth, exhaling through the nose. And I continue like that for a couple of minutes. At the end of the meditation, I raise my hands over my head, I hold my breath, and I suck my energy up the spine, holding the breath, feeling the life force in my body. I press my tongue on my upper palate, stimulating the pineal gland, and then I do a strong exhale through the mouth, imagining that I'm exhaling through the top of the head. You wanna pull from your anus and perineum, you wanna pull your sex organs in as if though you're wanting not to pee, and then bring your navel against your spine, and then send that energy into the rib cage through the throat. Press your tongue on your upper palate and then exhale powerfully through the top of your head.
Meditation doesn't have to be something you only do in a yoga studio or in the quiet of your own home.
One of the things I'm super passionate about and one of the messages of Allied Awareness is that you can meditate anywhere, anytime, that you don't need a special place or a special room, that cultivating awareness of your breath, cultivating awareness of your life force can happen anywhere, anytime. Meditation is really for anybody, and Kundalini yoga meditations were really engineered to be what's called a householder's yoga, meaning that you don't need copious amounts of time to connect to yourself on a very deep level. I feel like Kundalini yoga meditations are pretty hard hitting, and most people will feel some sort of an effect pretty quickly.
A couple of the first things that I noticed after practicing with Anka was my nervous system just completely gelled, which I hadn't experienced before. It felt very comfortable, it felt very relaxing, and it also allowed me to just focus on pinpoint things, which I was not quite as adept at beforehand.
For me, and I think for the modern world, Kundalini yoga meditations are really effective because they're really active. You're not just asked to sit and observe your mind. And I think that gets really confusing for people because the mind can take us on a lot of different journeys and tangents. Some of the tips when meditating is focus on the breath, focus on the sensation, to keep your mind, keep training your mind to come back to what is, not what your mind wants to invent and have you think about, but to really take this powerful tool that our human mind is and to train it to work for you, for it to be aware of present moment sensation. And that trains us to stay present. And that's what we want to gain through meditation, is more presence, more awareness, and more of our whole person and every aspect of our person being here now to interact with the wonderful things that life has to offer. The art behind meditation is a fusion of awareness with la dolce far niente, which is an Italian saying for the sweetness of nothing doing. It's the art of nothing doing and yet bringing more awareness into your life and into your body and into the world.
Coming up, a mini vacation you don't even need to leave your house for.
The way those droplets come out, it covers more of the body and it feels so much more luxurious and comforting.
That's all next on The Art of Relaxation. Welcome back to The Art of Relaxation. Not everyone has access to a sound bath or the means to meditate, but another way to unwind in your own home is by turning it into a relaxing getaway. That's what this busy mom did.
My name is Sarah Gaines, and I decided to renovate my bathroom. I'm a teacher, and I'm a new mom. I have a 9-month-old daughter named Bayla and a great husband named Matt. We wanted to make some sort of little oasis for me to be able to go in and relax. We decided we wanted to make it sort of Spa Sarah, we've been calling it. Spa Sarah to me is my 5 minutes to go in and just relax and get a few minutes to think to myself.
Renovating the existing bathroom was going to be incredibly difficult, so Sarah turned to a designer who's been helping stressed-out homeowners create their ideal interiors for years.
My name is Colleen Kinder, and I'm an interior designer, and I own a company called Platinum Coast Designs based out of Chicago, Illinois.
When I interview clients, the first thing I ask them is how they want to live in the space. Are you both going to be in the bathroom at the same time? Do you shower? Do you take a tub? You know, how do you live your life? And Sarah really knew exactly what she wanted from the beginning. She wanted a spa-like bathroom. She showed me lots of pictures of whites and grays and, you know, very serene bathroom, something that was very calming and quiet, but very sophisticated with a little bit of contemporary flair. The bathroom originally was about a third to a half of the size that you see today. One of the first things we talked about was reconfiguring it for modern day. They wanted a large, luxurious bathroom, and there happened to be a walk-in closet right next to it. We moved the walls around a little bit, reconfigured, and then created an over double the size of the bathroom, so we were able to incorporate a very large spa-like shower and a double vanity.
To help Sarah and her husband decide on which fixtures to install, Colleen brought them to the Dream 2O showroom in downtown Chicago.
Hi, Colleen. How are you? Good to see you.
Nice to see you. Thanks so much for taking the time to meet us.
My name is Kelly Litton, and I'm the manager of the Dream 2O showroom here in the Chicago Merchandise Mart. Our showroom is very unique in that the faucets are actually connected to water, and people can turn them on and try them.
So everything that you see on this island is with Delta Faucet, and we have a lot of different styles in Delta. We have contemporary, we have transitional, traditional. Is there anything that you would classify as your style?
I think Matt and Sarah are a combination between transitional and contemporary.
Okay, so yeah. Perfect. You might like this Addison here. So this kind of fits in both.
I like this a lot.
Yeah, like both styles. So cool thing about this faucet is that it's a touch faucet. Okay. So Touch XT is the technology for this one. You can turn it on and off like that. You can use it as a touch faucet and touch it on and off. Or it actually works. You don't even have to touch it. You can actually just put your hand within 4 inches and it will come on while your hand's there. Once you take your hand away, it'll go off.
That's really neat.
Very clean.
I like that. How was that, Matt?
It works.
One hand.
Perfect. So why don't we walk over to the showers and I'll show you a few things that you might be interested in.
Great.
Thank you.
So in this display, we're showing a lot of different kinds of showering. And I know that you're looking for something that's kind of relaxing.
Yes.
And H2O Kinetic has a feeling of a lot of relaxation because you have different droplet sizes and it hits you at different angles and it covers a lot of the body. So that might be something that you're interested in. And H2O Kinetic actually alters the droplets that come out of your shower head. So there's large and small droplets. The larger droplets retain heat a little bit longer, so your shower warmer. But the way those droplets come out in kind of an oscillating pattern like this, it covers more of the body and it feels so much more luxurious and comforting in the shower.
I like the idea of maybe the wall mounted versus the rain shower, and then maybe what we can do is we can add some body sprays to add to the spa experience. What do you think?
Oh yeah.
I'm all for some body sprays.
Sarah really loved the body sprays and the H2O kinetic shower head, and then adding in the hand shower. So the whole thing as a collective group really creates a very relaxing and spa-like experience. So I know the average person spends 8 minutes in a shower, but at this type of shower, I wouldn't be surprised if she spends a lot more time in it.
All the selections for Spa Sarah have been made, and just a short time later, the work is complete.
The first time I walked in and saw it fully complete, I couldn't believe it. I'm really happy with the decisions we made. I wanted light, I wanted airy, I wanted to keep it very clean, and I think that turned out great and it looks awesome in there. It really came together, everything. It's all just, I love it. Thank you.
I definitely think there's an art to relaxing. I think you have to teach yourself to stop and breathe, and you have to teach yourself to stop and relax. And I think going through this renovation play into that art. I just love that I can hold my daughter with one hand and actually wash my hand. It's the most fascinating thing in the world to me. I like my spa, Sarah.